Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no
place
to go,
morning, everyone. I was just staring out the window at the snow. Woo, it's a cold one today. It's going to be cold all week. As such, I'm bundled up. But I'm inside, so I don't need all this. More on this later. Oh my gosh, there is so much to talk about today. I'm so excited. So first of all, it's February. Woo! We made it through January, the worst month in the history of the world. I do not like January. It is terrible and it's over. I apologize to anyone who has a January birthday. If you have a January birthday, January is awesome. And there's so much going on this month. I don't know where to begin. So first of all, tomorrow is Groundhog Day. That is the day that Punxsutawney Phil tells us whether we are going to have more winter or less winter. Quite frankly, this year I'm torn because they're predicting a lot of snow for the week. And, you know, we haven't had a lot of snow. And this is the one year when snow, you know, is not an issue because we can't go anywhere. So we can just sit and look at it being beautiful. I know it's a pain if you need to go out and walk somewhere. But so I'm kind of torn about it this year. But no, of course, I want it to be spring. And it did snow yesterday, last night. I don't know about where you are, but where I am in Scotland, it snowed. And there it is, my back garden yesterday. The next thing is that this week is the grand opening of the LLMVC Student Lounge. So this means that, you know, all that social interaction you've been craving, now you can go to the Student Lounge and meet your friends, meet your course mates, have a cup of coffee, have a chat, play some card games, play some other games. You're probably wondering, but wait a second, Amy, we're in lockdown. We can't do that. It's not possible. It's illegal, in fact. And you are absolutely right. If the Student Lounge was an actual physical place, well, I guess it's physical. I don't know. It's a virtual space. And this is what it looks like. This is how you can move around in the Student Lounge, talk to people, meet people, and just have a nice social interaction. So that's why it looks like there's this little video game on the screen and is a whole lot of fun. So you should be hearing more about that. I've already sent a message out to the postgrads about the various meeting times this week and next. So look out for messages from your class reps about when you can meet in the student lounge. Of course, it's open all the time, so if you want to set up your own meetings, you can. And also, for staff, if you're listening, you're not left out because, of course, this week is the launch of the LLMVC Brasserie, and we are going to be meeting for coffee and drinks and different things. There is the Jazz Society is having its first jam session on Wednesday. So check that out. Check out their Facebook page. Sounds like a lot of fun. And I would also recommend checking out the Aberdeen Cine Club. They're always doing viewing parties or watch parties, teleparties, whatever they're called these days. And I've always been really curious about watch parties and how they work. So check them out and you can, you know, watch a film online with a bunch of people and talk about it afterward, kind of different from what we're doing these days usually, which is watching Netflix by ourselves and, you know, thinking about it by ourselves. So this way it becomes a group activity. Now it is time, that moment you have been waiting for. Today is the day, our very first special guest star. Yay! Who is it today? Who is it? Oh, it's a mystery. I'm sure you've been wondering. The special guest today is Professor Chris Collins, our new head of, well, he's not new, really. I mean, he started in the spring in the midst of the lockdown. He is our head of school, our fearless leader, the head honcho, leader in chief extraordinaire. And he is with us. Well, he's not with us now. I recorded this earlier, but with no further ado, here is Chris Collins. So I am delighted to say that we have our fearless leader with us today, Professor Chris Collins, head of the School of Language, Literature, Music, and Visual Culture. Hi, Chris.
Hi, Amy.
How are you doing today?
Not so bad, thank you. And you? I'm good. It's Monday, and it's my Monday message. So I just have a few questions for you.
Go ahead.
So my first question is, coffee or tea in the morning?
Tea.
And how do you take your tea?
White, no sugar. It's really important to me that the water is absolutely boiling and that it's poured on the tea bag very slowly so that it can infuse.
That is wonderful. So everyone listening, note that technique, and you know, you could try it yourselves. Now, have you ever tried cinnamon in your tea?
Not in tea, I have to admit. I've tried it in coffee, certainly.
Oh, okay. Would you consider trying it in your tea?
I'm open for new experiences.
Well, if you do, let us know how it turned out.
Okay.
Now, what do you have for breakfast?
I had muesli this morning.
Okay, good. And tell us, what is the one thing that you've done to help yourself cope during lockdown?
Probably, not working in the evening. Finishing at 5 o'clock and making a point of doing that.
I do that too. I try. Sometimes there's a little bit of mission creep, but I do try to end at 5. I think it's excellent advice. Well, thank you. Thank you so much for being with us today, Chris. It's so nice to see you. Take care.
You too.
And don't forget the cinnamon. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Thank you very much, Chris. That was awesome. So the last thing about February that I love is that it is the Super Bowl. And last week I told you I didn't know who was going to be playing in the Super Bowl. And now I do. And it is one of my favorite players, Tom Brady, TB12, as he is known. And that is why I was wearing my New England Patriots hat at the start of this segment. So the thing about Tom Brady is that a lot of people do not like him. A lot of people, I guess, love to hate him. So I'm just going to tell you why I like him. I am from Connecticut. I'm from New England, and our team is the New England Patriots. Would always be on. There would always be a football game on the weekends, and my cousin would be watching, and he would just be cursing the Patriots because yet again they broke his heart. Yet again they lost, and they were just not a great team in the 80s and 90s. And then comes a new era, right? So this team that was always the underdog, could never win, suddenly started to become good. And it started with a new coach, a new quarterback. And the thing about Tom Brady as a quarterback is that he was the 6th round draft pick. So he was the second to last quarterback to be picked. So I don't know if it's like that in the UK or in Europe, but in the US, we would have, you know, you'd be in gym class in PE, and it's like, okay, we're going to play volleyball. So two sides, you're the captain, pick your team, right? And, you know, so you pick the best players first, right? First of all, I was never the captain. And I was always picked last or almost last in gym because I wasn't good at sports, right? So this is the professional equivalent of being picked last in gym. Like, no one believed in him. And all you need to do is tell me that someone is an underdog and no one believes in them, and that's the person I'm going to believe in. Because I don't know, maybe, you know, they say that, you know, everyone loves an underdog story. You know, I'm always rooting for the underdog. If there are two teams playing and one's the underdog, I root for the underdog, unless it's my team, and then I'm always rooting for them. But anyway, so Tom Brady was with the New England Patriots for 20 years. He's 43, which is really old, not really old, but really old to play like professional football as a quarterback. And this year he moved to the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, which, you know, I don't blame him. Tampa Bay, it's nice and warm down there. And he is about, and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers were an underdog. Like, no one believed in them, right? And now they're going to the Super Bowl. And it's, if you ask Tom Brady, he'll be like, well, it's the team. And that's another thing I like about him. It's always about the team. It's not about him. So the Buccaneers are playing in the Super Bowl against the Kansas City Chiefs. You have the 43-year-old seasoned, experienced quarterback. He's won 6 Super Bowls, possibly he's going to win his seventh, which is like, I think the most a quarterback has ever won is, you know, that would be the most. And he's going up against a younger quarterback who's also really good and is going to have an amazing career. So it's going to be an interesting game. So next Monday, I don't know if I'll have watched the Super Bowl yet because it's on so late at night. So I might not be able to be ecstatic or not. But the other thing I like about the New England Patriots, and again, Brady doesn't play for the Patriots anymore, but they're still my team because I'm from New England. And there's this sign, there's this famous sign on the door when the team members leave the practice, you know, the practice building where the New England Patriots practice. And it has this list of rules. Don't listen to or fuel the hype, you know, speak for yourself. And my absolute favorite is ignore the noise. And that applies to just about everything. And that's what I've been doing lately to really get through lockdown is ignoring the noise, not watching too much of the news, not hearing, because every day it's like, oh, it's great. Oh, it's terrible. Oh, we're making progress. Oh, we're not. And it's, you know, it's will make you go crazy. So just ignore the noise. And that also applies to the noise that anyone is spouting about you. You know, you're going to hear throughout life, you're going to hear people say things about you. Oh, you don't have promise. You don't have what it takes to be such and such. Ignore it, just like Tom Brady did. And he went on to be, you know, this great quarterback with this great career. Don't believe these outer critics. Just listen to yourself. Believe in yourself. Follow your heart. Now I'm getting really mushy and sentimental, so I think it's time to end the Monday message. But remember, don't forget the cinnamon. Bye.